All right. Hi. So if you remember, we were talking about Student Picker. And what Student Picker was, is it was an application where you could click this big random dice button and it would choose a student randomly from the class, and then you could ask that student a question. So if we wanted to add students, what we'd have to do is we'd have to get up the settings, we'd have to click Edit Students, and we get a list of students. And then we had a little text area in a box, and we could add a student. And we could return as well. If we wanted to delete a student, we could long click on a student and click OK. Otherwise, we return a lead. We also wanted bulk adding of students, like if you had a CSV file or something. So you'd go to settings, you go to fast import, you'd copy some text from another source, you'd go and paste it back in our app, you'd click add, bada bing, you're done, and you click and leave. And then you could call them up using the random generator. Okay, so that's what our app was going to do. So what this video is going to be about is it's going to be about the student picker, and we're going to start making the UI. So you want to start Eclipse, and then what you want to do is you want to make a new project. You want to make a new Android project. So in the wizards, you can just type in Android, and if you got the ADT and everything installed, it should say Android Activity, Android Application Project, Sample Project, Project from Existing Code. I'm going to do Android Application Project. Okay, my application name is going to be Student Picker. My project name is going to be Student Picker. And I have my own domain. I could do a CA ualberta.css for Student Picker, but because I have my own domain, I'm going to do CA Software Process Student Picker. I don't like the old Androids, so I'm going to have a minimum requirement of 4.11. And that theme's fine. I'm going to target 4.3. That's all good. Go next. So it's going to create a launcher icon. It's going to create activity. It's not going to be a library. It's going to create in the workspace. I've got no working sets to add. I'll just choose this default stuff for now. This will just be the default icon. I'm going to start with a blank activity as the first activity. And the main activity will be called main activity. That'll be the main thing. That looks fine. So there's nothing else to do, so I go finish. All right. So now student picker's here, and I got main activity. Okay. First things first, we want to add a UI. So activity main is already open, and this is what student picker already looks like. So I'm going to make this a little bigger. Margins, gravity. I don't really know how to zoom in. All right. Oh, there it is. One, or perfect zoom. All right, so here's Student Picker. This is going to be the main screen, and this is a relative layout. I don't really like this text view, so I'm gonna click it. I click delete. I want a large text, so I bring that in, and I want it as tall and as wide as the thing. And let's see, can I choose anything? Alignment, padding top, padding right, visibility. All right, so the large text, I'm going to change that text, and it's going to be choose a student. Okay. And I'm going to change the name of the text view because these are bad names. So this is going to be chosen student text view. Update all the references? Yes, I want it to update all the references. Okay. And really, what that's doing is it's if you go look in Gen over here, you go look in r.java, you'll see that in here, there's going to be a reference to the stuff that I made. It should be r.java style. Well, normally it gets updated. So we got hello world is a string. Not seeing it. What about build config? Okay, well, maybe I don't know what I'm talking about. So anyways, this is auto-generated. Let's go back to it. Close it off. Now, that's going to be the text that we use. And if you notice, there's a little warning here. And the warning is it's a hard-coded string. We should use an @string resource. You should probably use an @string resource, but for the purposes of the demo, we're just going to do this. Now I want to add a button. This button is going to be added underneath the student picker, and I want it basically as big as I can get it. All right. And I don't like the name button, so I'm going to say choose a student. And this will be called choose student button. Yes. Okay. All right. Okay, so I'll save this. Let's check out this. There it is. So the point is, I have to save the XML file and then it will appear. Now, if you remember, here's our choose student button and our choose text view. And these values are generated. We don't want to mess with them. They come from our main activity. Now, this main activity is represented as XML. If we click the XML tab on the bottom here, we get to see the XML that defines it. So it aligns left, aligns right, aligns top, so forth, same thing. Align parent, line that one too. I'm pretty sure I can do this, and it's not going to blow up. So we'll go into the graphical layout, and it looks good. Okay, so we've got that one layout. So this is one screen. How do we make another screen? Well, what we do is we go to our res folder. This means resources. And these are where your bitmaps go for all your little drawable things. They'll be included in your APK file. But what we care about is the layout directory. In the layout directory, we've got activity main. So we want to add another activity. So what we'll do, we want to add another layout, sorry. So what we'll do is we'll add another other, and then we'll go to the Android folder here in the wizard, and we'll look for a layout, so XML layout file. So I'll click next, and then it says it wants a name. So the name will be, we'll say list students. Right, so it's going to list the students, and we're going to use the same layout as before, that relative layout. So see the layouts there, here's the layout. So I'm going to click that. Oh, and I have to call it a .xml. Okay, so I click next. I can say some stuff about orientation and other things, but I don't need to qualify it, so I'll go finish. So now we've got student picker. So this is blank. So if we go back to, let's go to Inkscape. If we go back to Inkscape, we can see that it's supposed to be a list of students and then a text area and an add button. So let's go add that. So let's do the add button. And we're going to go call this, remember, give it a good name. Add student button. Yes. Okay. And the text on the button is going to be add student, maybe just add. Okay, I'm going to save this. We've got a button in the bottom. Now I want to add a text field. These are, I'll go with plain text. These are fields that we can add in. I'll go with the person's name. Don't know if it's special compared to the other thing. I'll align it against add. We'll call this add student name text. Yes. Okay. Okay. We'll keep it blank. And now what we want to do is we want to add a list. So a good way to display a list is a list view. So I'm going to add this list view right here. Oh. I'm going to put it in the corner. I don't like that it's at the bottom. I want it to the top of the button. So now we see that item 7 is cropped off. Should be scroll bars, vertical. Okay, so what's this one say? Scroll bar style, scroll bar vertical. Okay, so it'll have a scroll bar, so that's nice. And so that's our student picker. So I'm going to save this. Let's look at the XML for this. We've got a button. The button has the ID student button, has a text add. Pretty simple. It's aligned to the bottom, and it says it's aligned to the right. Is it aligned to the right? Yeah, so it's aligned to the bottom right. And then we've got a text area. Edit text, and it's got the name add student name text, and it's a person name. I don't actually know what this does. Maybe it pulls something up, I don't remember. And then there's also the list view, and the list view is above the add student button. It's left and it's aligned parent left. It should also be aligned parent right. Save that. Let's view it. Looks sane. Okay. Line parent right. Okay. And those are the three things. They're inside of a relative layout. So the nice thing is if you can't figure out on this thing how to do it, you can just edit the XML. It's pretty nice. All right. So save that. And let's go look at r.java. See, we got choose student button. We got choose student text view. We got list view one. Oh, that's bad. So let's click on our list view here. List view one's a terrible name. Let's call it student list view. It's okay. So we've got student list view, save that. Saved r.java student list view, good. Okay, and we have one more screen. And that screen is the bulk screen. This add button at the bottom and then a big text area. So let's go add that. So I click on layout, I go new, and I go other, and then I go Android XML layout file, and I say bulk student import. Okay, bulk student import. We're going to use, I really like the relative layout because you can lay it out with your mouse. Finish. So we got bulk student import, and what's going to be at the top is a multi-line text. And this is going to be line to right. And I want it bigger, but I'm going to add a button first because that might be easier. The button goes that way. Button goes that way. The button is called add bulk button. Yes. Okay. And the button text will be add. That's good. And then I'll pull this down to add bulk button. Is there an alignment? Okay, looks fine. So now we got this bulk layout thing. Let's check out the bulk student. Pretty simple. button and an edit text. Okay. Let's look at r.java. Oh, I didn't change that. It shouldn't be edit text. It should be, what's a good name for that? Bulk student text. Yes, that sounds good. Okay. Let's check r.java after we've saved it. You got to go control S to save this stuff. It doesn't automatically save in a lot of cases. So now we've got the bulk student and all that stuff. Okay, so that's pretty handy. Okay, so we've now basically got the three UIs. We've got our main activity, we've got our list view, and our bulk edition. Let's just go back to our view and see if we got everything. That one. That one's not done. This one we don't have to do. This one's done. Okay, so we've mostly got it. So one thing we have to do in this one, though, is we have to add this to the Git repository. Okay, so this was in a different workspace, though. Workspace, what is it called? It's called Student Picker. Okay, Student Picker. So we can either make like a new, we can either try in here to share the project. So, well, we want to use Git. I'm not using CVS. But I do not really like the Eclipse Git interface. I don't think it works that well. So I'm going to go Git init. So now we started a new Git repo. Let's see. Okay. So now let's go back to, GitHub. Let's get my Git URL. Oh. Okay, let's go git add GitHub, or git remote add GitHub. I add that URL. Let's go git pull GitHub master. So it's pulling it in. And now you can see that we've got a README and we've got a license. So I'll go git status. All right. So let's go git add Android manifest assets gen libs res and source. Let's go git status. So other things we should consider adding is we should look at our settings directory. We might not have to share the settings, but the dot project is pretty important. So I'm going to add the dot project. Let's go git status. And what about our dot class path? Not totally sure. If you're working in a team, dot class path might be a problem. You could add it and then remove it later. It's up to you. Let me just see the project properties. Okay, we'll add project properties. Git status. LS bin. Yeah, we don't really want to add the bin to there. It'll get added later. Okay, if you want to add your ProGuard stuff, you can. I don't really see much point. So git status. I'll add the IC web launcher. All right, and then dot settings. All right, I'll add the dot settings. If my teammates don't like it, they can remove it. So now I'm going to go commit A, and we're going to add a big whack of files. So let's just inspect the files. XML, Java, okay, PNG, properties, more PNGs, some XMLs, the layouts, and then some more XMLs, the values, and the main activity, and we're not going to track the bin folder. I explicitly did not add the bin folder because I don't want .class files in. For your project, for your assignment one, you're going to eventually add the bin folder. But you don't have to check it in every time. At the very least, I just want an APK. Okay, so the comment here is going to be initial Eclipse Android app import made layout screens. Okay, and now I have to share it with my repository. So I go git push GitHub master, and if I refresh here, we can see a bunch of junk in here. So there's lots of stuff. Okay. So in the next part, we'll do like the model of the system, and we'll get down the code in it. Okay. So hope you enjoyed this. Hope you got a lot out of it. Basically just making Android screens. All right. Thanks.